I put the shield on. Very easy. The nicest part of this is one point of control. Now I have 2 points of control. If I'm very lucky, I can always disarm him by doing this. Yeah, if you're holding the sword, but you should, if someone does it, the counter is what you did. It's just letting it go and coming back on. You don't want to go for the disarm thing, because then he's just going to back off and blah, blah, blah. But anyway, it's like this. Boom. Control. Taking over. Putting in there. Okay? No. You want to follow up right-handers? It's the same. Same but different. No, I really want to say this about left-handers and right-handers. I think too many people is too concerned about left-handers. And they try to change their own style because they're fighting a left-hander. What they should be doing is dominating their style upon the left-hander, so he does not have a chance to do all his left-handed shit. And this is a basic technique. So... when he does the attack, I put the weapon in, put the shield on, and the kill. It's even nicer because this thing about body mechanics, the body likes, you know, you like to cross the body. If you can cross him, you see if do it again. Let's say I try to control him this way. It's much easier for him to get out of being controlled this way than it is if I'm controlling him this way.
You're walking both of them.
Yeah. And I, if I'm really great, I'll put the sword. Do it again. I'll put the sword on the shield. Don't do that for safety reasons. It's pretty cool, but don't do it for safety reasons. And play with it. Take the low, this low. Take this low. Oh, sorry. Oh, it's me. I have to put that. Do it again. Boom. Okay. Go on.